Hello everyone, I'm happy to meet you in another session of our class. And before you, I am projecting an image. I hope you may understand. So if you want to build our muscles, you have to do physical exercise. If you want to build your brain, we have to read our book. So let us take this as a starting point. And for a revision, I am asking this question. The image before, let us divide the image into two parts, the left and the right. So on the left part, you have water molecules, and the right part, you have the water molecules. Can you guess the left belongs to which type of water molecules and the right belongs to which type, in which form it will be? I cannot say the other word because you may get the answer. So if you guess the left belongs to water, then that is correct. The right belongs to ice, that is correct. Okay. So the left image is the water molecules in liquid form. The right image, the water molecules in solid form. Okay. So you see, in solid form, the molecules are very intact and it is lesser number of molecules. You can see it is very less number of molecules per unit volume. In left, if you see, there are more number of water molecules since it is broken. So water molecules are very near. There are more number of water molecules per unit volume. Therefore, it will be more density. And water, upon cooling, it forms a solid, which we call ice. Ice floats over the water. I think this is we discussed last class. Just to revise it, I am projecting before you. Okay, the right image belongs to solid form of water. The left image belongs to liquid form of water. And this is the same. It is in a three-dimensional structure. And because of this, the fishes live. So ice will be the top layer, below which water will be there. So that's for revision purpose. Let us go to our today's class. And today it is on alkali metals. The image you see here, it is for Creative Commons. CC means Creative Commons. And these PPTs can be shared for non-commercial purposes. NC means non-commercial. And that is why it is they have put /. And the last one, you can share alike. On this video, it can be share alike. So you can share alike. It can be used for non-commercial purpose, and it will be in the public portal. That is why Creative Commons. Okay. Therefore, we use these symbols for that. So we do see alkali metals in the following categories. Alkali metals properties, which are categorized, which are divided into physical and chemical. And let us move to alkali metals. What are alkali metals? So you know these things, but anyway, these are revisions here. And this is what the meaning of an alkali. An alkali is a substance which produces hydroxide ions when it is dissolved in water. So the right part, you can see an image where sodium, upon dissolved in water, it goes to N plus and OH minus ion. It holds good for any other elements in this series. If you take lithium, if you take potassium, so all things dissolves in water and it produces hydroxide ion. And that hydroxide gives the character alkaline properties, which is a basic properties. So alkaline is basic properties. So therefore it is called as alkaline metals. And see what are those. The first group in the periodic table, we say it is alkali metals. Okay. In this, the hydrogen is the exception. Remaining them, we can name them along with the symbol Li, lithium, Na, sodium, K, potassium, Rb, rubidium, Cs, cesium, Fr, francium. So all these elements belongs to the group called alkali. Exception, hydrogen we are studying separately. That's what we started our unit with, hydrogen. Now we study the rest of the members except hydrogen. So that is called alkali metals. Okay. So now we go to properties. And in properties, now we will see physical properties. So what we mean by physical properties, what we see here, see or hear or feel or touch, smell, measure, all these things we call it as so physical properties. Okay. So let's go start with one and we will end with six. So one, alkali metals are soft, shiny, reactive metals. You have seen sodium, potassium, they are very soft. It can be cut with our knife. So let us see it. See, it's a very soft like bread. So you can cut it with knife. And these are very reactive. We are also going to see the reaction. They are thermal and electrical conductive. We said it is a metal and therefore metals will conduct electrical and thermal heat. So both it will be conducted. And third, they are luster, ductile and malleability. So it can be, you can press it in the form of sheets and you can also put in the form of wire. So ductility and malleability. Luster means it gives some shiny like thing. Okay, luster, ductile and malleability. So fourth one. So these metals are very soft and also low density, hence it floats on water. Fifth one. All the elements possess outermost orbit only one electron. Therefore NS1 general configuration holds good for all the elements from lithium to cesium. The last is very important one. See, one of its member, it possesses photoelectric effect. When sun rays fall over it, it ejects electron. So that member is cesium, and for that we are using in solar panels, and it gives electricity. Even in our NMBS2, over the top you can see this. So our full NMBS 1, 2, we have solar panels through which we get electricity, and that will be utilized. So these are the physical properties. Alkali metals are soft, they conduct thermal and electrical, they are luster, ductile and malleable, they have low density, and common electronic configuration, what is it? The common electronic configuration is NS1, and then cesium, it ejects electron when sunlights fall over it. And still little bit of physical property. So let us go to the atomic and ionic radii. So what are the atomic and ionic radii in your group? We have read, no, in periodic properties. In your group, as you move down top to bottom, the atomic radii increases. You can see as you move top to bottom, the atomic radii increases as a new shell get inside. As a new shell is created, as you go from top to bottom. Same it will be for ionic radius. So ionic radius also increases from top to bottom. Okay. Then let us go to the ionization energy. Ionization energy is the energy required to remove the outermost electron in an orbit, in an atom. Suppose if the atom is there, if you remove an outermost electron, we have to provide some heat energy. So the amount of heat energy required to remove the outermost electron in a gaseous element, then that we call it as ionization potential or ionization energy. Then how it will be? So it will be like this. So you can see the ionization energy of lithium is more than the sodium, then the potassium, then the rubidium, and then the cesium. So cesium possesses least ionization energy and the lithium possesses more ionization energy, and hence as soon as the sun's light falls over cesium, it gives the electron because it possesses less ionization energy. Okay. And also we'll go to the important property next. The next is the reducing property. So reduction is the reducing property is how much easily you take the electron. How much easily you take the electron means, so lithium easily we cannot take the electron, whereas cesium we can easily take the electron. Therefore lithium is a low reducing power, then sodium is low reducing power, then potassium is low reducing power. Then this is, and you can see the first line, and this part you can see. Okay. And then suppose, so this in case of this, if you put reducing property, cesium is more than rubidium, is more than potassium, is more than sodium, and then more than cadmium. So from right to left you can see, so cesium is more and the lithium is very less, so it is in the increasing order. But this order, it is does not holds good in case if it is in solutions. If it is an element, this holds good. But normally, whenever you take an element, if you want to make a reaction, generally the reactions are carried over in aqueous solutions. So in aqueous solution, the order little bit changes. Sodium, lithium is of more reducing agent than all the other members in the group. Let us see how. See. The first is cation, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium. All these are cations. You can see the ionic radius. Ionic radius increases from lithium to cesium. You see, when we dissolve these elements in water, it readily dissolves. But you see the enthalpy of hydration. Hydration means is the amount of energy released. Ionization potential means you are giving the energy to knock out the electrons. Enthalpy hydration means ionization as energy is released when the element is dissolved in water. You see what is for lithium? Lithium, it is 515 kilojoules per mole. That much amount of energy is released, therefore it is a negative sign. In case of cesium, it is 263 kilojoules per mole. Therefore, lithium possesses more enthalpy of hydration when dissolved in water. This enthalpy of hydration is useful to knock out the electron present in the lithium. Therefore, in aqueous solution, lithium acts as more powerful reducing agent, not in the elemental form. In an aqueous form, lithium will be a, that's why we have changed the equation. You can see the equation. So you see the equation, the first line will be lithium is lesser than sodium, is lesser than potassium, is lesser than rubidium, is lesser than cesium. The equation, it will be little bit changed if the elements are in aqueous solution. Lithium is more than sodium, all the elements, it is more, it's having more reducing property. It's a good reducer in an aqueous solution. Okay, so have you understood the reason? Okay, then the last in the physical, the electronegativity. See, these elements, you can, only one electron, it is present in the outermost shell. Therefore, it can be easily removed. It becomes a cation. Therefore, this possesses a strong electropositive character, and therefore, hence, it is a less of electronegative character. You compare the properties of lithium with that of the fluorine. Fluorine takes an electron instead, whereas lithium gives an electron, readily gives an electron. Therefore, this possesses electropositive character. Let us move to the second one, chemical properties. See, these elements are highly reactive with oxygen. Therefore, normally these elements they won't keep in an open container. Even if you keep inside a container, it is placed inside some liquid where it does not touches the atmosphere. Generally, they are sodium, potassium, they are stored in kerosene, like this. If you are not keeping kerosene, slowly it starts, reacts with oxygen inside the blood. And it forms a luster, it forms if you, like rusting. Suppose if iron is there, after some months, you can see iron oxide over it. Likewise, just if keep only sodium in the bottle, sodium oxide will be formed over the surfaces. Therefore, you can't get the pure sodium. Suppose you want the pure sodium, we will keep inside the kerosene. even for lab we need only little bit sodium. Suppose for a chemical industry, they will be having kilos, tons of sodium. All these tons of sodium they will put inside a kerosene, and also they will put in AC room, where the room, the large room, where the room in which the sodium is kept, it will be fully in under a low temperature, like 10 degree or 15 degree. Otherwise, this will be exploding. Okay, we'll see also that reaction little later. So these are the equation: lithium reacts with oxygen, it forms lithium oxide. Sodium reacts with oxygen, it forms sodium oxide. Potassium reacts with oxygen, it forms potassium. Like that, it goes. Even the alkali metals, the potassium Lewis system, it forms, it reacts more vigorously and forms its superoxide, where superoxide means O2, so KO2, rubidium O2, and cesium O2. So this is the first chemical property with that of oxygen. So the second chemical property is that of the water. All metals are very reactive, and if you put the metal in the water, the reaction is very vigorous and sometimes it leads to explosion. What does it forms? The metals reacts with water and forms metallic hydroxides. So that's why we call alkali metals, and this is basic condition: lithium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, rubidium hydroxide. All these are basics, and it evolves hydrogen gas. So let us see that reaction. So now I am taking you to the YouTube, where you can see the reaction. So a person is putting sodium in water. This is the reaction. How vigorously it goes. Now it is in slower pace. See how vigorously it reacts with water. That is why these metals are kept under kerosene, even sometimes alcohol. It is kept in an AC room if large quantities are there. If it's very small quantity, like our lab, we keep in bottles alone. But in large quantity in industry, they will keep inside a refrigerator room, where the temperature is maintained around 10 degree or 0 degree Celsius. Okay, this was the reaction with water. So halides. So metals reacts with halides and forms metallic halides, like lithium with chlorine, lithium chloride, sodium with chlorine, sodium chloride. So all these things we know. So it forms chlorides with chlorine and fluorides with fluorine. And the second point here, it is reactivity decreases from fluorine to iron. So fluorine is more reactive, then chlorine, then bromine, then iodine. So this is more reactive. And one exception is the lithium halide, or an exception with more covalent bonding because of high polarization of small covalent ion. See, in ionic bond formation, we have seen Fejan's rules. So if the ion is so small, in ionic bond, it turns to covalent. So only in case of lithium halide, there is a little exception, because it forms rather than it forms an ionic bond, it forms a covalent bond because of small size of cation. Okay. So reaction with acids like HCl, H2SO4, and HNO3. All these mineral acids, all these metals react with acids and form it responding salts. Like with HCl, it forms metallic chloride. With sulfuric acid, it forms metallic sulfate. With nitric acid, it forms metallic nitrates. So it reacts with all acids and forms its respective salts, and also evolves hydrogen. And oxoacids means, so if it reacts with acids and forms MOH, that H in OH is called oxoacids. Acidic proton is on the hydroxyl group, that we call it as oxoacids. For example, this one, in aqueous solution. In OH minus, that H is there. That H we call it as an oxoacid. Okay, so this also we have seen, all metals react with water and it gives sodium hydroxide. We'll finish this class with a lighter note.
Okay, double click on my computer. I can see your computer.
No. Click on my computer on your computer.
How can I click on your computer from my computer?
There is an icon labeled my computer on your computer.
Double click it. What the hell? What is your computer doing on my computer?
Double click on your computer.
Which icon do I have to click?
My computer.
Tell me where do you live? I go to your house to click on your computer.
Oh my god!
Okay, thank you very much. Just to finish a later note, I used it. Thank you very much.